The Israeli government is being accused of allowing the country to become an increasingly racist state. The criticism follows a move by dozens of rabbis to ban Jews from renting property to Arabs. The CBC's Margaret Evans reports.
Carmiel, a town nestled in the hills of the Galilee in northern Israel. It looks peaceful enough, but Carmiel is home to some ugly stirrings these days. A campaign to keep Arab Israelis out.
This is my
video. Sufian Habe is a computer programmer. You can see the Arab village he grew up in from here. A space shortage prompted him to move his family to Carmiel, but it wasn't easy, even though he speaks fluent Hebrew. I found many suitable apartments on the internet, he says, but when I called, they heard my accent. They said they don't rent to Arabs. Now, some 50 rabbis from across Israel have weighed in, signing an edict forbidding Jews from renting or selling homes to non-Jews. Our Torah says specifically that the land of Israel belongs to Jews, he's saying. It sparked protests and brought censure from Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. But critics say the policies of Netanyahu's own right-wing coalition are turning Israel into an increasingly racist country.
Well, the Arab community is feeling more and more against the wall. It is pushing the Arab community to small corners of delegitimization of its citizenship.
And he says it's being backed by legislation. A whole series of bills making their way through the Israeli Knesset that Arab Israelis believe are aimed at making them second-class citizens. Most controversial, the so-called loyalty oath. It will require new citizens to swear allegiance to Israel as a Jewish state, no matter their own ethnic or religious identity.
But critics say it will only set Israel's Arab minority even further apart. People like Sufian Habe. Ending discrimination against Arab Israelis, they say, would do far more to inspire loyalty to the state.
Hello, and welcome to another edition of Esoteric Worldviews on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. Today I'm going to be reporting, reading from an article in Al Jazeera English, which talks about the racism in Israel at an institutionalized level. This story is about hundreds of Israeli rabbis which have signed a religious edict forbidding Jews from renting or selling homes to Arabs. Real nice, Israel, real nice. You know, Arabs who live in Palestine, to my understanding, are simply Jews who were converted to Islam in the late 8th century. And the Jews, ironically, which have come quote-unquote back to Palestine, are actually from the kingdom of Khazaria, which is in Ukraine. And that's why that they're white-skinned, because they're from Central and Eastern Europe and not from Africa. I mean, come on, African Jews are white-skinned. Semitic white-skinned Jews? It doesn't make any sense to me. If you're Semitic, how are you going to be whiter than me? You know? I was reading an esoteric book entitled Esoteric Psychology by Alice Bailey, that there are three strains of Jewish racial genetic. One of them is the Mizrahi, the dark-skinned Arabian type Jews. Then we have the Spanish. Spanish are actually Hebrew, Hasidic. Spanish people are actually Hasidic. And Celtic, so the gingers, the Irish looking Celtic, white skin with orange hair. Those are also the original Jews. But these Ashkenazim Jews, which come from Khazaria in Ukraine, are not even the real Jews. So let's read the story from these false Jews about other people who might just be Hebrews, who they're calling Palestinians, who are now, you know, dirty Arabs, and who are these dark-skinned bandits, you know, invading their land. Okay. Hundreds of Israeli rabbis have signed a religious edict forbidding Jews from renting or selling homes or land to Arabs or other non-Jews. That means you, Americans, who are not Jewish. The public letter instructs Jews to ostracize those who disobey the order, which is widely viewed as an attack on the country's Palestinian citizens. When the decree was announced on Tuesday, it had been signed by 50 rabbis, many of whom are employed by the State of Israel as municipal religious leaders. Despite sharp public criticism, another 250 rabbis have added their names to the proclamation. A similar edict was issued by the city of Safed less than 2 months ago, when over a dozen rabbis banded together to urge Jewish landlords not to rent apartments to Arab college students. That's so fucked. African refugees, a group that the state refers to as quote-unquote infiltrators, and migrant workers have also been targeted. This summer, 25 Tel Aviv rabbis signed a proclamation that forbids Jews from renting to quote-unquote infiltrators. 10 real estate agents who work in neighborhoods that are home to large populations of African refugees answered the call, publicly stating that they would refuse such tenants and would not renew the leases of those who are currently residing there. All of this on the basis of their skin color. And in late November, the municipality of Bnei Barak, an ultra-Orthodox suburb of Tel Aviv, because these Africans, they claim to be Jewish, began notifying migrant workers and African refugees that they would be evicted from their homes in the weeks to come. But Tuesday's proclamation, which was signed by rabbis from across the country, is the largest of its kind. Small demonstrations were held in Tel Aviv and in Jerusalem. And in Jerusalem, protesters were met by counter-protesters screaming lefty traitors. A number of rabbis spoke out against the edict, calling it a distortion of Jewish religious law. A prominent rabbi remarked that the signatories must be stripped of their pens. That is so true. A prominent rabbi remarked that the signatories must be stripped of their pens. So all of you, all of you secular people who are commenting on my videos and trying to tell me, like the last one, the Tunisian video that I made, oh, it's not about religion. It's not about religion. It has nothing to do with religion. Well, with this story, it is about religion, definitely. And with Tunisia, you know, it's about religion because they want free economic system, yes, and they're going to get that under a caliphate. That's why it's about religion, in another sense. Either way, after his comment, two rabbis removed their name from the letter. After a comment of a prominent rabbi, two other rabbis removed their name from the letter. Wow, really powerful, you know, spiritual forces these two rabbis are, that they're so flim-flammy. Made me sick. You know, I could pull better rabbis out of my ass for you, Israel. Just let me know. After this comment, two rabbis removed their names from the letter, but others dug in their heels, announcing that they would collect another 500 signatures against renting or selling Arab properties to Arabs and other non-Jews. You know, this is kind of like the case of in India, where there's this mystery over the word Aryan. The word Aryan does not refer to white people in Indian Vedic history. The word Aryan does not refer to white people. It refers to a noble, dignified person as an Aryan. So I believe that something else might have been going on in history in terms of Jews. I don't think that there was this discretion between Jews and non-Jews. I believe that originally it was probably such that everybody on the planet was of the 12 tribes of Israel, and you know, people who were religious were held to these religious laws, and people who weren't. I believe that has to be what it is. The edict was condemned by many members of the government, including Benjamin Netanyahu, the prime minister. How would we feel if we were told not to sell apartments to Jews? Netanyahu said at a Bible competition in Jerusalem. We would protest, and we protest now when it is said of our neighbors. You're right, Netanyahu. Avishai Braverman, the Ministry of Affairs minister, called on the state to fire one of the rabbis involved. And the Israel Religious Action Center, along with the Coalition Against Racism, lodged a formal complaint. So this is just madness. This is what's going on in Israel right now. And, you know, as a personal message, if any Israelis are watching, you know, you have a special position in this world, to be, you know, guardians of religious purity. It's what you're supposed to be. It says in the Bible that in the end times, Israel will be a curse unto all the nations, and then after the end times, equally Israel will be a blessing to all the nations, and her peoples will be high priests again. So I believe that, you know, Israel, you have a special place in this world. You have a special obligation, a special promise to keep, a special place to exhibit and shine. And you're not doing a good job right now. Well, maybe it's supposed to be like this, but you shouldn't be spiraling down into racism and bigotry. You know, you're better than that, Israel, or you should be better than that.